everyone, and thank you for coming. My name is Laosha Tillman, and I'm the Assistant Program Director for CHP at the Navigation Center right over there at Civic Center Hotel. The work we do here is so important, especially in this COVID pandemic era, because we are providing shelter and housing for the less fortunate. I am very excited to be a part of this groundbreaking of the Coton Project. This project will provide 96 more people with housing opportunity that is greatly needed. Today, we have a special guest to help us kick off this critical and groundbreaking project. At this time, if everyone would please join me in welcoming San Francisco Mayor, Mayor London Bree.
Thank you so much, Laosha, for the introduction. Thank you for the work that you do with Community Housing Partnership. I gotta say, it's nice to be outside with people. We are still in the midst of this pandemic. We know that so many people are still hard at work, and we are excited to break ground on this project today. It takes a lot of work, it takes a lot of effort, but today is a good day as we break ground on 96 units for formerly homeless individuals. As we provide a plan around homelessness, our homeless recovery plan involves making sure that we are transitioning people out of our shelters, out of our hotel rooms, into a permanent situation. This is what it's all about. And having incredible partners to make this possible is so critical to the success of this city. So I'm really glad to be here. Hell, I'm glad to be anywhere nowadays. Thank you all so much for being here today.
First and foremost, I very much want to thank the mayor for coming out today. This is going to be 96 units of permanent and supportive housing for folks currently unhoused. And this is going to give folks a key to put in their hand, a home to have for as long as they want, and some ability to stabilize their lives, have dignity, and choose to move forward in whatever way makes the most sense for them. Our partnership with the city is deep and very wide. I want to particularly note that we couldn't do this without the funding from the city, the Mayor's Office of Housing and Community Development, which is providing substantial funding for the construction of the project. Once the project is built, in order to continue to provide services in the building, we have a contract with the Department of Housing and Supportive Housing, which will make sure that over the long haul, folks get the services they need to succeed with their lives. So part of the funding that we have in this project comes from the state of California, from the Housing and Community Development Department of the state. There's also low-income housing tax credits that are part of the funding that make this project possible, which is a partnership for both the city and the federal government. And it takes all of those entities and the complexity of putting them all together in order to create the housing that folks need in order to thrive with their lives. We wanted to focus on this site in not only being a great place for folks to live, but taking our responsibility in stewarding the planet. And this is going to be a Greenpoint rated building, thanks to the work that our architects have done.
Hi, I'm Daniel Simons, principal with David Baker Architect. We've had such a great team that we've been working with. It's going to be a really wonderful building. It's a really sustainable project. It's going to be all electric. We had an unusual opportunity in that due to the proximity to BART, we were required to put a basement in, and we took full advantage of that basement by daylighting it and filling it with program space for the residents of the project. It's also a really unique project in that it's part of this larger development that's going to include a public park, and it faces right on the public park in this neighborhood of San Francisco where there's not a lot of open space. Any building is satisfying. The process is always really challenging. Getting something built feels good, but it's especially good when you're serving a population that needs it as much as this population.
We couldn't do this without the money from both the investors and the lenders. So our primary tax credit investor, Enterprise, which is in the business of supporting these kind of projects, despite the fact that this was going on during COVID, stepped up, figured out how to get the financing in place with all of the complications we all remember back in May, June, and July, and got it done.
All of us at Enterprise are pleased to invest over $23 million in 53 Colton. This permanent supportive housing aligns with our mission, which is to make home and community places of pride, power, and belonging, and platforms for resilience and upward mobility. We're so pleased to continue our partnership with CHP and the City of San Francisco and look forward to the day residents move in.
Hi, I'm Lee Aller with Merchants Capital, and I'm proud to be the lead construction lender for 53 Colton. Building affordable housing is never easy, but CHP's leadership kept everybody focused during the global pandemic and California wildfires. Merchants' mission is to finance affordable housing across the nation. 53 Colton is the embodiment of this mission. On behalf of myself, Susan, Katie, and the entire Merchants team, we want to celebrate with CHP and everyone involved. Now, as your construction lender, put on your hard hats and get back to work, because we look forward to meeting everybody at the grand opening.
We are very proud of the fact that we're doing this in partnership with the Plumbers Union. We are a union shop at Community Housing Partnership, and the idea that we could do something in partnership with the Plumbers Union really meant a lot to us.
Not only is this a great investment for our members and their pension funds, but like I said, it's great for the community and the surrounding area. And to be able to help the lower income and formerly homeless people into some permanent housing is vitally important and something we're very proud of to be a part of. This project will create much needed housing and much needed union jobs at this point where it's slowed down a little bit because of COVID. We have unemployment in my union, but this is one of the only jobs that's kind of got started during COVID. We're proud of that. And I want to thank all the union trained building trades construction workers, some of them you see over here. I want to thank you very much for the hard job you guys do and a great job you do every day.
And we are really lucky that the Strata Development Company, which does huge projects, which we're just a small part of here at this site, really saw the opportunity to work with us, figure out how we could do a permanent supportive housing project, blend their deep expertise in larger projects with the particular issues associated with affordable housing, and our teams have worked extremely well together just making this possible.
53 Colton is supportive permanent homeless housing that's actually part of a larger private development project. Through some of the unique transactional structures that Mayor Breed was alluding to, including us contributing the land and $10 million of private equity, allow us collectively to deliver supportive homeless housing on a super efficient basis. As is so often the case on a hard project like this, the only way you do it is with collaboration and partnership. What's unique here is there are so many partners. We literally had the public sector, the private sector, the nonprofit sector, and organized labor all come together working towards a common goal. And I'm not sure if people know this, but it was in large part because of personal outreach by Larry that the AFL-CIO Housing Trust came into this project and as part of the financing for 53 Colton.
I'm Ted Chandler with the AFL-CIO Housing Investment Trust. Congratulations to Community Housing Partnership and Strata SF on breaking ground on 53 Colton Street. Last Labor Day, we announced our $1 billion commitment for rental housing in the Bay Area, and we're thrilled that 53 Colton Street is our first project under construction. We are also proud to be standing with UA Local 38 Plumbers and Pipefitters Redevelopment, as well as all the men and women of San Francisco's building trades and Community Housing Partnership's dedicated union workforce.
From the very beginning, the mayor's office asked us to think outside the box, and that included allowing the Civic Center Hotel to become a temporary navigation center. I don't know if it's the case, but I think it's still the only navigation center in San Francisco that's actually on private property. And even more importantly was the idea, again, of deeply embracing that we are going to have permanent homeless housing as part of a much larger project. And, you know, in San Francisco, you have to do a lot of work with neighbors. We spend a lot of time with the neighbors here. And really, one of the keys to getting the neighbors around this site comfortable with the idea of homeless housing literally in their backyard was the reputation and track record of CHP. We are absolutely thrilled to be a catalyst for San Francisco's next great urban village. So thank you very much.
This is such an important project for our city. It is going to be a part of a larger transformation of this neighborhood and the area all around us. The reality is the future of this alley is thankfully going to be one of housing, of hundreds of units for people in our city, especially people who are in need in the future when many people live here. I'm looking forward to hopefully being able to represent them and work with them and be a part of a larger revitalization and transformation of this neighborhood. I'm so happy for all the jobs that will be created. I'm so happy for our city and the hundreds of people who will be able to call this entire village home.
All right, we ready?
Thank you.